Today on Ask Me Anything Science Edition, we're talking about
bubbles. So, Mom, why when you blow bubbles does it pop?
Ah, good question. So it's all about forces. So there's air inside that's pushing out, and there's air outside that's pushing in. And in the material, there's a stretchiness that's called surface tension. So if there's more pressure pushing outwards and you get a little bit of a tear, then the surface tension in the material rips the whole thing apart and it pops.
Ah, that makes sense.
Like this.
There we go.
You want to try this out in more detail with a balloon?
Yeah.
All right. So what do you think will happen if we take this skewer and we touch it to the side of the balloon?
It'll probably pop.
Okay, it'll probably pop. But did you know that there's actually a way to put this skewer through the balloon without it popping?
Really?
Do you want to try it?
Yeah.
Okay, so right by the knot where you see that it's kind of stretchy and
right
not, it's darker, there's not as much surface tension, so put it through there.
Right.
Okay, push, push. Okay, all the way through. Now if you look on the other side, opposite the knot, there's a little bit of a bump where it's darker than the surrounding material. So see if you can get it lined up to come out through.
Where's the bump?
That.
I don't know where the.
There's the bump.
Wait, where's the. You keep messing up my skewer. Where's my skewer? I don't know where
my
skewer.
Okay, so push it through. Push it through. Till you, oh, there we go. Okay. So see, we can put it right on the bump. Woo! So we push it through and ta-da! We have our skewer through the balloon and it hasn't popped.
Although it's kind of losing air.
So we can pull it all the way through and the balloon is still fine.
Except it's kind of losing air.
Well, a little bit because there's now a tiny hole. But there's nothing magic about this balloon. If we do this.
It's like magic. Okay, no, it's not magic.
It does the exact same thing you predicted. Where at the side, there's more surface tension. So as soon as you make a little hole, the surface tension rips the whole bubble apart.
Fun!
Totally. And did you know that bubbles and balloons are fun, but they're also useful?
Really?
Yeah. Remember that video we were watching about the emperor penguins trying to get out of the water quickly?
Oh, where they like fluffed up their feathers with a bunch of air and then they dove down and then they created a bubble of tunnels, a tunnel of bubbles to come up there?
Yeah. They come shooting up through this tunnel of bubbles. And what that does is it makes it much easier for them to swim through the water. So they can get out of the water up to like 3 times faster than if they just came swimming through the water, which is pretty useful if there's, say, a hungry sea lion in the water.
Yes, very useful.
Mm-hmm. So there's a demonstration that you can do at home to look at the same kind of thing, not exactly the same, but similar, the effect of bubbles on materials in different liquids. So we've got some fizzy water here that we're going to put into a container. And then we've got some raisins. So what do you think is going to happen if we drop the raisins in the container?
They'll sink.
All right, let's see what happens. Drop the raisins in.
All of them?
Not all of them, just like a handful. All right, let's see what happens.
Wait, whoa, like the bubbles, like picking up the raisins. And then when they get to the top, the raisins are like, the bubbles are coming off and then the raisins sink again.
Yeah, this is what we call dancing raisins. What's happening is exactly that. The raisins are kind of rough, so it's a nice spot for the bubbles to accumulate. That's what we call
bumpy raisins.
Nucleation. So the bubbles accumulate on the raisins and enough bubbles accumulate, they lift the raisin to the top, the bubbles evaporate away, and then the raisin sinks back down again. So you can try this at home. All you need is some raisins and either some fizzy water or some pop, whatever you like, and you can make those raisins dance.
Oh, is this like the thing with Mentos and Diet Coke where like the Mentos are rough, so when you put it in the Diet Coke, there's like a million bubbles and then it spews out the top?
Absolutely. So it's the same thing as the Mentos and Diet Coke demonstration. The Mentos are rough and they are a nice site for a bubble nucleation, and you get that as the bubbles all accumulate on the Mentos if you drop them in quickly. Do you want to try it?
Let's do that.
Let's do it. Okay, so that was fun. Blowing up Diet Coke with Mentos using nucleation on the rough Mentos. What do you think?
It was fun, but I feel like it could be jazzed up a little more.
Jazzed up? That wasn't jazzed up enough for you? You need it amped up more?
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
I'm thinking, like, you know those machine things where it's like dominoes hit like a ball or something and then it hits something?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Like a Rube Goldberg machine.
Yeah, those things.
You want a Rube Goldberg machine, a Diet Coke and Mentos demonstration?
Yeah.
I like the way you think. Let's do it.
Okay, so this is my Rube Goldberg machine to blow up a bottle of Coke. We're gonna start by shooting the weather vane with the hose. And then it's going to hit the Jenga blocks. I've taken out pieces in case they get knocked over by accident. Then they're gonna hit the ball into the bucket. And these buckets are balanced, so when the ball goes in, this one will go down, this one will go up, and when this one goes up, it'll lift the gate and let the car go down the track. And then it's gonna fly through the air and hit this post, which is gonna let the ball swing and hit the chicken. And when the chicken gets hit off the teeter-totter, these Mentos are gonna go down the tube and into the Coke bottle and then explode.
Thanks for watching Ask Me Anything Science Edition.
And don't forget to send us your questions if you have something that you're wondering about.
Have a science-tastic summer. And blow lots of bubbles. I popped your bubble.